We are back, and the very next video up is the Snap It by Lindberg, 125th scale, 96 Crown Victoria Police Interceptor model. Squad cars are always highly popular, so when I saw that Model Roundup got in just a limited number of these kits, it's a little bit older production kit, but they got it in, and a lot of you like to collect these squad cars and all the different variations. So they sent me over a copy to get it built up. I will link down in the description where to snag it. When it's gone until it's reissued by something else, but you can go in right away when you see this video and get that word and get that kit right away. I'm gonna start building up mine, but we're gonna show you what's all in the box first. It is a press fit kit, so you're gonna have basic detail on the chassis, but when I say basic, really, it's not. I mean, A-arms, engine, transmission, catalytic converters, exhaust, differential, sway bars, fuel tank. I mean, that thing looks just like the real Crown Vic underneath. Extremely well detailed for a press fit kit. Holy cow, linkages on the suspension and everything. Even though it's solid, that you can go up. I'm going to go and paint some of that stuff. Bring out the detail, a little bit of dry brushing. It's got a cage in there. Keep the perps in the back from getting ruckus, causing some rowdiness. We've got some radios with antennas. They're kind of small. We'll get the camera to focus. We've got, looks like a police radio and SCMADS system from Blues Brothers. They got SCMADS. They're going to find out I got no license. We got a center console with instrumentation. So that's nice, police car details on there with that cage and everything. We've got the side mirrors to the car. They'll be pressed in. It's rare you see side mirrors on a press fit kit. We've got a large interior tree here. We've got a very nice detailed dashboard. We've got the airbag steering wheel, the control column, the steering column with shifter, turn signal indicator, tilt wheel. We've got our front bucket seats and seat backs. We've got our rear bench. We've even got a little taillight molding in there. Carpet detail. Got some ideas for the interior to kind of spice it up a little bit so we can see more when we look inside. Nice door panel detail too. On a snap-tight kit. Really surprised by that. We've got the coolest Crown Vic body. We all know these things. And I didn't know this when I got the kit. It's pre-painted in white with black trim, silver callouts on the door handles, silver trim all the way around. Wow. And it's a beautiful gloss paint job. Look at that. That needs no work whatsoever unless you wanted to repaint it. Bring out a little detail with a magic marker on those windshield wipers. Do the trim up and you're done. That is really sharp and definitely fits the part. Got the rear molding. We'll do a little black wash underneath there. Bring out that detail, but holy cow, was I ever surprised to see that body done for me. That's you know, that is a lot of work completely done. That is outstanding and it's beautiful work. Whoever masked that off and painted that, excellent work. Black trim underneath. Of course, there's no engine detail because it's a press fit, but wow. Again, really impressed by that. We'll go to the other side. There's even more cool stuff. We have two metal axles and four screws to hold it together. We've got some clear parts for the lights on the kits. We've got the reflective base to the light bar that we'll just press into the roof we saw. And this side's up, this side's down with those posts. We saw the body was pre-drilled for those. So we've got those all set up. We've got some spotlight lenses, if you choose to install the spotlights on your car. We've got pre-tinted taillights. Yes. How awesome is that? Left and right, of course. Individual, pre-tinted. I mean, they're doing a lot of the work. Check this out. Pre-tinted bubbles. No Tamiya clear needed. Holy cow, this thing is so cool if you want to have a fast, easy kit. We've got a set of Goodyear Eagle RSAs. See how close the camera can focus on that. Nice tread pattern. black wall one side, Goodyear Eagles on the other. Four of those, they are solid vinyl. So you'll be able to push your wheels through there. Speaking of the wheels, here's those Crown Vic hubcaps. You flat coat those, you run a black wash inside, they're going to look extremely real, like steel wheels. We've got the front headlight assembly, all as one with the marker turn signals. The grill even looks blacked out, though I can get a little bit more in there. But the turn signals are done. I mean, they really, really went all out to make this a fun, easy police car build. We got the clears for the mirrors. Get it? Rhymes. We've got the spotlights, which are a complete option on the car. We've got the large glass all the way around. Of course, the perp doesn't get to open his windows. You're going to jail, bad boy. Large one-piece window. Looks nice, little future floor polish on that. What else is left? Well, not one, but two sets of water slide decals. First one is in that awesome shredded flag concept. Wavy flags, got the shreds, got police logos, got USA1 logos. Looks awesome, made by Cartograph. So you know they're going to be high quality decals. Then, Illinois State Police decals. Dash decals, Ford logos, police interceptor logos, badge logos, Illinois State Police striping. Yes, this kit's got it all. It might be a press fit kit, but it sure is well detailed. I'm going to start getting mine together. We'll be right back. It took me longer to mask things up than it did to actually do any assembly and thing. It's super, super easy on this kit. We got the dashboard ready for paint. I've got my own idea for this kind of car. So I kind of want to do it as like the captain's car, who always gets a little bit of a nicer car than your regular patrol cars. And that's how I want to do mine up in, and you can do yours as yours and whatever. But this is how I've seen different squad cars in my life. So this is how I'm going to be doing mine. Got the steering wheel assembly pressed together, super easy to do. And what's nice is it's got that nice large pin for press fit, so I can paint it up right there. Leave the tree on the dashboard, can paint it up, and it's all the way hidden down here, so when I cut it off, no one's gonna see. Gonna get the police radios painted, and I'm just gonna get them in a black to get the plastic look off of it, and then I will be hand detailing everything else. Got the cage ready. Definitely want mine to have the cage since it's available in the kit. I masked off the upper part. I want that to stay black. The bottom part and all the ones I seen were like a raw aluminum. So I want to paint it up that way just to give a little bit more visual interest when we look inside the car. We'll be able to see a little more detail. The two seats just pressed together. I will sticky stuff those to my painting turntables and get the entire seat painted all the way around before I push it in the interior. In the back, I want to leave that plastic look on that back seat. All the squad cars that I've seen with the cage and everything always have that hard plastic seat or the vinyl seats. They never have fabric or anything back there, but I want to paint the rest of the interior. So I mask that completely off and we'll get some interior color paint on that. The wheels are going to get a coat of matte, flat clear, and then we'll show you how to highlight those inside like I've done on numerous other vehicles. And the chassis really doesn't need it, but since I want to do some hand painting, I also want to take that shine off that. So I will be spraying that with a flat black primer as well. We're going to get over there right now. That is it for subassembly before I start working. I'm going to start shooting some color right now. Time to approach those last steps. Check out for a press fit kit how sweet this thing is. We've got the light bar here with its little speakers or vents in it. I black washed inside those, then put the light bar on. So it looks awesome, and you can even see the little bubbles inside because they give you the lenses for that. That's pretty tight on there, all pre-colored. Got the lenses glued into the spotlights. I'm not sure if I'm going to use them or not, or maybe one or both. We don't know. Got the mirrors. Obviously, I'm going to be using the mirrors. So I got the lenses pressed in there. Held in with a little drop of super glue. They weren't held in very tight, and I didn't want them to fall out because I knew I'd lose them forever. But those are ready to be pressed into the body. The wheel and tire package is sweet Crown Vicness. Got the tires sanded. Got the Goodyear logos out and got those hubcaps black washed and then wiped clean. Doesn't that look really awesome? That is absolutely cool looking on there. Those definitely make the car. We got the bottom of the chassis all set up. We dry brushed it to highlight all that beautiful detail if you didn't see it earlier. Then we painted up our parts, including the sway bar and everything, and that's ready to go. The body's all set. We got the glass in. We got the grill in. See how much nicer it looks when you black out the actual deep recesses of the grill? Got the sides done. Got the grill and everything pressed in. Went in beautifully. The taillights were a little loose. I held them in with some Mod Podge. You've seen me use that before. It's just like a white glue that won't fog glass. So the taillights look awesome. Then I used a little bit of silver on the latch for the trunk. Did a little bit of black trim around the windows so that they are all set and we are all ready to go with that body. And then really sets it off, especially for a snap tight as that interior. Got all the instrumentation and the police radios and the walkie-talkies back there. Got that dashboard looking awesome. Beautifully detailed. Over that black, you can see that brings out all the detail, including the vent and everything. That's that khaki sprayed over black. We got the back seat in the black. Got the cage with the aluminum guard underneath. That is just going to look great. That's got a lot of glass on that car, so that's going to look real nice inside. All I have to do is press everything together, screw it together, and then apply my Illinois ISP, Illinois State Police decals, and we're all done. So I'm going to do that right now. It's just going to all press fit and screw together. I'm going to put the decals on, give it a coat of future over the top of those decals to seal them down. When I come back, we'll be done. Here it is, the most modern police car I have done, and one of the iconic police cars, the Police Interceptor Crown Victoria from Ford through Lindberg, 1/25th scale, sent over by Modelroundup.com. They've got a limited number of these available. In the box were the Illinois State Police emblems. You can also get this really cool shredded flag logo set. One thing you should know about the decals in this kit, they did have to soak for a little while longer than normal. Normally in hot water, they come off within 10 seconds, 30 seconds. These ones needed to sit with the water on them for about 2 minutes, and then they slid right off. They didn't break, they didn't crease, they didn't do anything, and they settled down beautifully. I used just a little bit of Tamiya decal solvent along the side, and they laid right into the door lines and the gas can lines and everything. The Ford logos, the little tiny ones, came right off and adhered to the wheels. The Crown Vic Police Interceptor logos, the license plates, the back bumper stripe, everything went down beautifully. The dash decals went down lovely, and we have an excellent looking model. Yes, it is a snap tight curbside, so you can't open the hood, you can't display it, but these things are boring unless you like looking at hookup wires from a battery and a couple extra fuse boxes. Crown Vics weren't made to show off the engine. It's all black underneath and plastic and wires and air conditioning lines and extra coolant lines and a bunch of fuse blocks, so it doesn't make any sense anyways. Underneath, we got just a mild bit of weathering. Nice new-ish car, sort of new to being delivered to service, and then we are all set up. It does roll freely, so you can glue those in place. I did up the interior the way I wanted to see it, with that vinyl black back seat, the fabric khaki front seats, the black and silver cage where we've got the black rubber coated cage on top and the aluminum shield underneath behind there. We got all that awesome radio equipment inside. I attached just one of the spotlights. I left the other one off. I figure if this, I'm doing it up as the captain's car, we're only going to have one spotlight. He doesn't have a partner, so they only sent it in there. They gave him a little bit of a fancier car for himself to use. He hardly any hauls anyone in the back anyway, so they didn't worry about it too much. Excellent model. I love the wheels on that. Those are a spot-on match. The tires are nice and tall and skinny like an actual cruiser cop car would have, not the low pros or the pimped-out wheels or tires or anything. It is a very fine model. If you like to collect police cars, there are lots of places to pick up police car logos from all the different states. I'd like to get a set and do up a Wisconsin State Patrol one in that nice deep blue that the WIS Patrol uses. But you can grab as many of these as you can while they're available from Model Roundup. I'll put a link down in the description. And then you can start building up your fleet of different squad cars or daily drivers. I mean, just don't put the logos on it. Fill in the two little holes on top for the bubbles and you have Grandpa's Crown Victoria without any trouble. So you can detail it up that way. You can go mild as a squad car. You can go wild with those awesome decals. Do whatever you want with it. Just make sure that you have some fun. And that's what modeling is all about. Enjoy your kits. Have a good time. Build them to the best of your ability and just enjoy your hobby. Thanks to Model Roundup for sending this over. We've got more kits from them coming up. Thanks to you for being cool viewers, and we will see all of you at the next review.